It is important to note that we need to have proteins in our diet. We have some amino acids that we refer to them as essential amino acids. It simply means that we need to get them through our diet, and then our cells can actually use those amino acids to build the proteins that our body cells actually need. And about 10 to 35% of the calories that we need per day should come from proteins. And please recall that breaking down 1 gram of protein produces about 4 calories. So this is the importance of having enough protein in our diet. And now we start talking about how our digestive system breaks down proteins and eventually give us the amino acids that we absorb into our blood. In our digestive canal, the first place that we start chemical digestion of proteins would be inside the stomach. Recall that in gastric juice, we have a very high volume of hydrochloric acid. As soon as proteins get inside the hydrochloric acid, this acidic substance is going to denaturize the proteins. So that a little bit simplifies the structure of especially the complex proteins. However, the enzyme that inside the stomach is going to break down long chains of proteins into smaller chains of proteins is an enzyme named pepsin. So let's see how we get pepsin inside the stomach. In the lining of stomach, we have non-ciliated simple columnar epithelium. And some of these columnar cells are referred to as chief cells. Chief cells release an inactive enzyme named pepsinogen. So pepsinogen is inactive. It simply means it's not going to really break down anything till it becomes activated. After chief cells release pepsinogen into the lumen of stomach, then pepsinogen interacts with hydrochloric acid and becomes active. So we can say hydrochloric acid is the one that activates pepsinogen, and the active enzyme is called pepsin. Pepsin is the one that in the lumen of stomach breaks down long polypeptide chains into smaller polypeptide chains. But it is important to note that pepsin is capable of digesting the proteins that we have in the membrane of the cells. So we have to protect the cells that line the stomach from enzymes such as pepsin. How do we do that? We use 2 strategies. One, the mucus cells that line stomach release a very thick layer of mucus. It's about 1 to 3 millimeter of alkaline mucus that covers these cells and protect them from pepsin. And also, as you noticed, chief cells never release pepsin. They do not release the active form of enzyme. They release inactive enzyme, pepsinogen, and later inside the lumen, pepsinogen becomes active, turns into pepsin, and then pepsin can actually start breaking down proteins. So that's about how we digest proteins in the stomach. And then we know that chyme through pyloric sphincter enters into the lumen of small intestine. From pancreas, we receive a group of proteolytic enzymes. We call all of them pancreatic protein digesting enzymes. Recall that we have the main pancreatic duct, duct of Virson. Also, we have accessory pancreatic duct, duct of Santorini. And in this model, duct of Virson joins common bile duct and forms hepatopancreatic ampulla. So those pancreatic protein digesting enzymes are released into duodenum of the small intestine. And recall that all enzymes that we get from pancreas do the chemical digestion in the lumen of small intestine. Those 4 groups of enzymes that are released from pancreas to break down proteins are trypsin, chymotrypsin, carboxypeptidase, and elastase. The difference between these 4 groups of proteolytic enzymes that we get from pancreas is simply the peptide bonds that they break down are located between different amino acids. So what these enzymes do in the lumen of small intestine, they break down those protein chains into even smaller chains of proteins. And then the last enzymes that finalize digestion of proteins, and give us those nutrients that we can absorb them through the wall of small intestine into the bloodstream are brush border enzymes. So in the lining of small intestine, we do have absorptive cells. The absorptive cells produce brush border enzymes, and two of those brush border enzymes are peptidases. Basically, it means their expertise is to break down the peptide bonds between amino acid molecules. One of them is called aminopeptidase. That's the one that cut off the amino acid at the amino end of a peptide chain. And the other one is dipeptidase. Dipeptidase basically break down the peptide bond that we have between two amino acids. Recall, dipeptide means two amino acids are attached together by a peptide bond. And the dipeptidase is the one that breaks down the bond between the two amino acids in a dipeptide and give us two separate individual amino acids. And then we start absorbing these amino acids through the wall of small intestine into bloodstream. So as you notice, digestion of proteins start in stomach, and then in the small intestine, we continue the digestion of proteins and we finalize the digestion and end up with the nutrient molecules, amino acids, that we can absorb into the bloodstream. Hope you find this helpful.